Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Modern Java course. To talk about newer versions of Java, we first need to make sure we're all on the same page. Java 8 is relatively old by now, but if you've been around, away from Java, you might not be familiar with everything it has to offer. We need a common baseline for the rest of the course, so this is where we'll start. Java 8 was one of the most important releases in Java's history. It has a stupid amount of big new features, but it was also important politically. It was the first version of Java built and released under Oracle after it acquired Sun, the creator of Java. Technically, Java 7 was released under Oracle too, but Java 7 started development before the Oracle purchase was finalized, and was still very much a product of Sun. So Java 8 had to prove to the world that Oracle is a worthy successor. The biggest feature of Java 8 by far was the introduction of Lambda expressions into the language. A Lambda is an encapsulated block of code that can act as a callback. The following code shows the creation of a thread before and after Java 8. A Lambda in Java defined the concept of a functional interface, an interface with a single method that can act as a function. In this case, the runnable interface is used as a function. Since the compiler knows the thread class expects a runnable, it knows the expected type. Since runnable has one method, the arguments are the only thing we need. The run method doesn't take any arguments, so there's nothing to pass along. A major benefit of the Lambda is the shorter, fluent syntax. Reduction of noise is indeed a major benefit of this feature. But there's another subtle difference and an advantage. The difference is in the scoping behavior. An anonymous inner class has its own scope, but a Lambda is considered a part of the surrounding scope, since the anonymous inner class can access variables in the parent scope. The difference is very subtle, but it's there. Take into consideration this code. Let's say the field is null when we create the instance of the runnable object. After we create the object, we set the field to a new value. The inner class will still have a null value, while the Lambda won't. Why is that? An inner class, or anonymous or otherwise, is a separate class. The compiler adds a hidden constructor that passes the extra parameters, and they are copied on construction. This can create subtle odd behaviors, such as a null in some edge cases. But the important thing to keep in mind is that values are copied in construction. A Lambda will reference the actual variables and will update as the variables update. This has a second implication. When we compile Java code, it's compiled to a format called bytecode. This format is a relatively simple machine code format that matches the source code relatively closely. The JVM compiles or interprets that bytecode when running the app. A Lambda expression doesn't generate the same bytecode as the new expression you see above it. While it will act in a very similar way, it's still a different implementation under the hood. A Lambda will use invokedynamic bytecode, which is a new bytecode instruction added in Java 7. This means the Java 8 block won't allocate a new runnable object with every execution of that block. A Lambda is more beautiful and it's faster. Lambdas are great, but they can end up as long and distracting blocks of code. We might want to extract some Lambda logic to a method for reuse on other blocks, or we might want to invoke just one method. Why do we need a Lambda for that? Method references are a different syntax for Lambdas that invoke a single method. This isn't 100% accurate, since there are some subtle differences in implementation. but semantically they are very close. We can convert any Lambda to a method reference and vice versa. Continuing the thread example from the Lambda explanation, this would be the method reference version of that. Notice that we don't pass brackets to the method reference. It's assumed that the method doesn't accept arguments here. But this isn't always the case. If the Lambda accepts arguments, the method would need to have an identical signature to process the arguments. Some people consider method references superior. I'll reserve judgment on that. Pick what works for you in your code. In the next video, we'll talk about default methods and streams. Follow through the videos to check out the full course. If you have any questions, please use the comment section. Thank you.